U.F.O.s, please come back with us.
I'm sorry, but I have to do my job. Let's go back.
Please come in.
Come on, let's get out of here.
No, wait.
With your friends, Dr. Marvin.
I'm coming with you.
Please come in, all of you.
I'm going to phone headquarters.
You'd better do as they say. Thousands of miles away from the Earth.
And in a matter of seconds.
You are many miles away from your planet, but not in a matter of seconds. Listen to your watch, Dr. Marvin.
Stopped. It's supposed to be anti-magnetic.
We generate a magnetic field stronger than the gravitational field on your Earth. This is the principle by which we move through space. We have adjusted the magnetic field to compensate for the normal loss of gravitational effect and atmospheric pressure. But your watch hasn't stopped. Feel your pulse.
I haven't any.
Neither have I.
We operate in a very different time reference. You might say all this is happening between the ticks of your watch or the beats of your heart.
And that's why we couldn't decipher your message till it was too late.
It made it necessary for us to defend ourselves at Skyhook.
Then you shot down our 11 rockets. Why?
At that time, we had no way of knowing they were only primitive observation posts. We thought they might be weapons directed against us.
Who are you? Where are you from?
Because of your leadership in exploring the field of outer space, we felt you could best understand that we are the survivors of a disintegrated solar system. At this moment, the remainder of our fleet is circling your globe. Waiting a signal to tell them where to land.
What do you want with me?
Arrange for your world leaders to confer with us in the city of Washington.
They may not listen. I'm only a scientist.
We will show you how important it is to convince your leaders. In an instant of your time, we travel from beyond your moon to the surface of your Earth.
Men on that ship.
Speed, maneuverability, and force.
With a weapon like that, why don't you just land and take over?
To do that would cause worldwide panic. Despite our power, the few of us would be busy indefinitely trying to suppress a large hostile population. In the end, we would be masters of a wrecked and hungry planet.
What makes you think you'll conquer us without a fight?
We felt it would be best to meet with you so fighting could be avoided. Such agreements have been made on Earth before.
How do you know so much about us?
We have the means of accumulating information. If you wish to convince yourself about our detailed knowledge, test us. Any question?
What's the size of the armed forces of the United States?
There's approximately 3.5 million men.
Well, what team has won the most World Series?
The New York Yankees.
Who was the first president of the United States?
Washington.
I know that voice.
Who are you?
John Hanley.
My father. What have you done to him?
You have been addressing General Hanley's mind, not General Hanley. Look behind you.
Dad.
He will not recognize you. He has been subjected to a machine we call an infinitely indexed memory bank. We have transferred all knowledge from his brain to our machine. Thus, we have available and readily accessible his total experience. We can do this to as many as we like and learn whatever we must know.
Oh, stop it. Please stop it.
Put that gun away. Don't look at that.
This is the beginning of the process by which we read the brain for the infinitely indexed memory bank.
What have you done with my father?
We will return him to you eventually. And the police officer, too. Will you arrange a conference for us?
We will tell the authorities you want one. That's all we can do.
I'm not going to cooperate with these monsters.
It may take weeks or months to set it up.
You will have two of your lunar days, or 56 days Earth time.
Let the killers now be done with.
Please, Carol. If our officials don't believe me, I can't be held responsible.
When you tell of the destroyer being sunk, refer to latitude 30 degrees 20 minutes, longitude 45 degrees 15 minutes. They will believe you.